the biggest part of the decision for me and for my family about whether I could attend rabbinical school wasn't, you know, whether I wanted to or whether I was excited to learn Torah, but it was about whether we could afford it. My name is Maria Polzetti, and I'm a student at Reconstructionist Rabbinical College. So I'm a lawyer. I've been practicing law for 15 years. I was a public defender handling death penalty cases for a long time. So I've always done work that was really morally driven. And yet, as I grew older and as I became a parent and as I became Jewish, I was increasingly shifting and seeing the world and the type of communal obligation that we find in Torah, and really looking to have a role that could connect with people in a space where we could recognize the possibility of transcendence, God, which of course I don't do in my legal work. And so I found increasingly that I was looking for opportunities to do that. And eventually someone said to me, are you going to go to rabbinical school? After I was admitted, I didn't really know what to tell people because I was, there were some months between admission and financial aid package in my path. I'm actually still working part-time at Community Legal Services in Philadelphia, and I focus on public benefits. I focus on access to the social safety net. So I've actually advised quite a few RRC students about their access to programs like Medicaid and food stamps, which RRC students use.
Health insurance is a big question that every rabbinical student comes in with, like, what am I going to do for health insurance? My name is Stephanie Breitzman. My pronouns are she and her, and I am a student at the Reconstructionist Rabbinical College. Prior to rabbinical school, when I was applying to school, I was working for Americans for Peace Now, caring for other people, both in pain and in joy, and trying to help people feel more whole in their lives. That's what my rabbis did for me, and that's what I want to do. So the prospect of doing rabbinical school was pretty daunting financially. I have a previous master's degree and a whole bundle of student debt from that. So the thought of adding more was really stressful. And I, in full honesty, like, I am still taking out student debt, but the scholarships make it manageable. Like, it's the only reason that I was able to come here.
I think in an ideal world, we would be training rabbis. The people who we would be training are the people who are most passionate about Judaism and most passionate about sharing Judaism with others, not the people who can afford to go to graduate school for 5 years, right?
Reconstructing Judaism requires different perspectives and different experiences to bring to the text and the tradition. And a lot of those different experiences don't come with generational wealth.
I try as I get older to not worry about the things I can't do anything about and focus on the things that I can do something about. Rabbis were always a very important and meaningful part of my life, and I wanted to make sure that we could continue to train them. In 2005, my grandmother passed away. She was the major influence in my life, and I think she would be so proud of the fact that there's a scholarship named in her name, because she realized how important a rabbi could be in someone's life at really critical times.
I have, you know, a different set of financial obligations than someone who's not parenting. So we're so grateful as a family that there's scholarship support for students like me.
I receive about like half of tuition in scholarships, and that's life-changing for me. I needed that.
Without the generous financial contributions from donors, I wouldn't have had the opportunity and the space to explore the multifaceted nature of what it means to be a Jewish leader.
We need to help more people become rabbis, and that's a financial commitment as well as a time and energy commitment.
RRC's commitment to bringing in students who, from a range of backgrounds and from a range of financial means that my classmates are teaching me, and I hope that I'm also teaching them, that their experiences are from where we teach Torah. We're vessels of Torah, and our vessel itself is part of the teaching. And I want to learn from people who haven't had the same life as me, and I think that the whole Jewish community benefits.
People in our congregations need to know that we just don't exist as a little independent congregation? Where do we think all of this great stuff comes from? This is all part of the whole of Reconstructing Judaism.
When you establish a scholarship fund, you are helping educate a rabbi, not just a rabbi this year, not just a rabbi next year or the following year. You're helping to educate rabbis, plural, forever.